is a message to all my friends. Let me tell you about something that's happening, about a movement called the Great Awakening. The QAnon phenomenon is going mainstream. This time is coming round to use the evidence and bring them down. And we'll all just laugh as they fall and crawl, 'cause where we go one, we go all.
So I want to play some audio from Rudy Giuliani. He was on Waters World on Fox on Saturday night, and here is what he said.
I have what I used to call, when I was a U.S. attorney, a smoking gun. This is a money laundering transaction. It occurred just at the time that Shokin was fired, and it's about $14.6 million. And this is a notice from the Latvian government to the Ukrainian government that Hunter Biden is under investigation for corruption affair. And then it lays out, I'll simplify it, $14.8 million goes from Ukraine to a company in Latvia, mm-hmm. disguised as a loan. Then it goes from Latvia to another company disguised as another loan in Cyprus. And then it goes to the U.S. We lose track of it, because when Shokin gets it, just about the day he's fired, there's no money in here for Devin Archer and Hunter Biden.
So this is the document that I showed you last week. Rudy Giuliani is releasing this now. We released this last week. This went to Senator Grassley's office. What was it, on Friday morning? And they are investigating Hunter Biden now for money laundering. This is the prosecutor's office from the Republic of Latvia, Office for Prevention of Laundering of Proceeds Derived from Criminal Activity. This was sent to the Ukrainian FIU, that's the Financial Intelligence Unit. The subject is Burisma Holding Limited. Let me just read it to you. It says, "Dear colleagues, the Office for Prevention of Laundering of Proceeds Derived from Criminal Activity," further in text, the Latvian FIU, "is currently investigating suspicious activity of Burisma Holding Limited. According to publicly available information, Burisma Holding Limited and its director, Hunter Biden, are involved in a corruption affair. The following transactions made to Burisma Holding Limited account as Pravat Bank are known to the Latvian FIU. From July of 2012 until July of 2015. Now, by the way, this memo was issued before Trump was in office. $14,665,982 and €336,015 were received from WireLogic Technology as payments for a loan agreement. Now, if you watch the show on Thursday night, you realize that loans are the way this happens. You loan somebody, you know, a bunch of money. They make payments on that loan. It's all in dirty money. Then they default on the rest of the loan. The person who's been cleaning the money says, okay, well, we're going to cut our losses here, and we'll send you back your $1 million, if you will. But we're gonna keep 10% of it, because that's our fee for such a hard time doing business with you. So loans are the way money laundering happens. So the first one is $14 million, just almost $15 million. From WireLogic Technology, then from July 2015 till December 2015, a total of $1,964,375 were received from Digitech Organization as payments for other loan agreements. The funds were partially transferred from Burisma Holding Limited account to Devin Archer, Hunter Biden, Alan Apter, and Alexander Kwanasniewski, I think. See attached for partial movement of funds. The Latvian FIU turns to the Ukrainian FIU and kindly asks for the following information. Are the mentioned companies known to the Ukrainian FIU? If so, for what reason? Please confirm if any of these persons are suspected of corruption or any other criminal offense, and if criminal proceedings have been initiated. Is there any information that the funds transferred to Burisma Holding Limited account have criminal origin? No, they had an origin of us. On the grounds of possible legalization of proceeds derived from criminal activity and corruption, please grant us permission to share the information included in the reply to this request with Latvian law enforcement entities for intelligence use purposes only. That's the whole memo. That's what it says. Post this at glennbeck.com. But this is what Rudy Giuliani says is the smoking gun. Jason Buttrell is with us, and Jason has been on this particular document since we got it in December.
Can I just put the timeline in context?
Yes.
So that is, what's this say? It's February 20th.
This comes out February 18th, 2016.
Okay. So this is sent at a time when the left and the media has told everyone, all of you, that there was no investigation going on at the time with Burisma.
Mm-hmm.
So firing the prosecutor general, Biden getting him fired, had nothing at all to do with the investigation because it was dormant. You know, we've heard that all over the place. It was dormant.
Right.
Now, that memo was sent just a couple of weeks after we have shown you in the Ukrainian media that that is false, that Shokin, the prosecutor general, started seizing the property of Burisma, started seizing it. And he said in an interview that his very next move was to interview very specifically Devin Archer and Biden Jr.
Okay, so this memo comes out before he files that, that court move?
After.
After.
That's the Latvian government saying, oh, there's this case. Look what we found.
Correct.
Would this be interesting to you?
Right. And then Biden comes just a couple of weeks later, does he not?
Yes, and gets him fired.
So the media is shown by this document as being total and complete liars, that there was nothing going on. Everyone had looked into it. There was nothing. This was a bad prosecutor. We told you on Thursday that's not true because of this document. This document in place with the prosecutor general in Ukraine, him, his paperwork, which we have also shown you, filing court proceedings to go after Burisma for money laundering and corruption, then this document, then 2 weeks later, Joe Biden comes in and gets that guy fired.
Right.
Now tell me that there was nothing going on. Tell me that this was a dormant investigation. It clearly wasn't.
This is a case that, which you pointed out on the special, that they had been on since 2014, money laundering from Burisma. They knew money was getting put into Burisma, and it was just going poof. And it was all coming through Privatbank, which it says in that document as well.
And by the way, when we're talking money, your money, $1.8 billion of your hard-earned tax money, gone, just disappeared.
And now most of that money goes to shell companies, which we cannot track. That's why this is so crucial. Because most of the time it goes to a random shell company in Belize or Cyprus or whatever. Now we have a firm destination that's not a shell company, and it's a U.S. citizen. Laundered funds went to Hunter Biden, as per this document. So now do you see why this is so important for us to look into him? It has nothing to do with politics. We now have the end point for some of this laundered money that might be our $1.8 missing billion dollars, and it goes directly to Hunter Biden.
If it's not our part of our $1.8 billion, this is the system they've used to,
right,
to launder our $1.8 billion. It is not as important to make sure that Hunter Biden is arrested for this, and maybe Joe Biden or anyone else involved. It's, to me, more important that we find out what happened to that $1.8, because it explains a lot. It explains the entire Russian relationship right now. I believe that the federal government could verify that there was a secret war that was authorized by Barack Obama against Russia. He didn't want anything to do with Russia. He wasn't for wars. That's not his style. A million miles away. But Hillary Clinton and the State Department, they knew what that meant when the Maidan was happening and the revolution was coming. If the United States didn't stand with Russia or didn't stand with Ukraine, Russia could have crippled them. But if you have a president who doesn't want anything to do with that, what do you do? John Kerry actually confirmed while on the campaign trail in Iowa for Joe Biden. Do we still have that clip from last week where he is confirming that, yeah, this was known from the top? And it's interesting because what he says was, we had to get that prosecutor out, not because he was corrupt, but because we had to win the war of Maidan, which is the name of their revolution. We had to win the war. Ukrainians had to win this war. Listen.
I will tell you, because as Secretary of State, I was deeply involved in this. All of us in the administration were trying to get rid of that prosecutor. From Obama to the Secretary of State to the Vice President, all of us were working on that. The ambassador and we knew if Ukraine was going to survive and win the revolution in the end, the Maidan, they had to get rid of that prosecutor, and they did.
Why? Why would they have to get rid of that prosecutor? Why would they have to protect something that they had the documentation on that was in a major international money laundering scheme, and that Hunter Biden was specifically involved and named by a foreign country as a recipient of some of this foreign money laundered money? It doesn't make any sense.
And even more so in the context of this prosecutor hadn't even been on the job for a year yet. Not even a year. They try to make Shokin out to be this crazy bad guy that was, he was there for, I think, 10 months at this point. 10 months. Like, how many cases could he even looked in at that point? The other prosecutor that was, that I think everyone conflates with Shokin, he was the guy that wouldn't look into a lot of cases. And so they got him fired from the get-go. That was right after the revolution, the Maidan, this one prosecutor. And the
because the one thing the Ukrainian people want is a cleanup of the corruption. They know the corruption is what's killing their country.
And wasn't Shokin initially Obama's, like, chosen replacement for the corruption?
Yeah, we've had two of good guys that became prosecutor generals. The first one was Shokin. And he was like, get rid of that one guy because he won't investigate some of these things. This was back in 2014. So Shokin goes in. Then he's literally on for a handful of months. And oh my gosh, somehow he became this crazy guy we have to get rid of.
Because of the, quoting John Kerry, we had to get rid of him if we were going to win the revolution. What does that even mean? What does that even mean? Unless you're laundering money and you are using the main recipient, Kolomoisky, who we've told you about, is far worse than Tony Soprano. This is the guy who executes his rivals with a chainsaw to the neck. He beheads with chainsaws. Why did we, at the same time we're getting this from Latvia, saying, hey, they're laundering money, why at the same time is Joe Biden saying, you know what? Give him a visa. He's a good guy. He can do international business wherever he wants. His son is working for him. $1.8 billion goes into his bank where it suddenly disappears. Then he's made a governor of the state, one of the states in Ukraine that's right at the war lines, the battle lines of Russia, where all of it is heating up, and that guy becomes known as the guy who finances the war against Russia. This is really not that hard to figure this out.